Welcome to the Cinema Couch.
And now the trailer for A Girl Most Likely.
Stick around after to see what we think about it.
And the Tony Award for Best Play goes to Imogen Duncan.
Oh, thank you so much. Oh my gosh. There's so many people that I want to thank. Most importantly, my wonderful Dutch husband, Peter. How van elke dag?
Imogen, you've had a meltdown.
Really?
Mrs. Duncan, would you be willing to assume responsibility for your daughter?
Well, I have to be somewhere later.
The best thing for your daughter would be to be in the care of a loved one.
She said she loved me?
No, but we have more critical patients that need her bed.
Hi, honey.
You cannot do this!
Oh,
I can't go there. Please, call the police!
Honey, your panties are showing.
Bring me a joke.
Hey, you left me in the back seat of your car. I locked the doors in a casino parking lot.
Jane, you're back.
Why did Mom run out my room to some random guy?
Ow!
Oh,
God!
Jesus.
Someone's in here!
I'm sorry.
This is my boyfriend. He's in the CIA.
Hi, George Bush.
Your name is George Bush?
The guy is a compulsive liar.
George doesn't lie. He's just lived a life so exciting it sounds made up.
That's because it is. Were you getting spanked last night?
Oh. It is so much fun. Have you never tried it?
A lot of people had a worse mother than you. Like me.
You shouldn't be mad at your mother.
And what exactly qualifies you to say that to me?
In the samurai tradition, when a man loves a woman, he becomes a spiritual guardian for her offspring. I'm getting resistance.
Yeah, a little bit. That's accurate.
I don't care!
Just come out with us.
That sounds like fun, but we're practically from a different generation.
I forgot that hanging out with regular people could be such an enthralling experience.
Oh my God, my mom had that same vest.
Cool.
I don't care. I love it.
If I say I'm sorry, I'm worried that you'll just get all mad and yell at me for ruining your life.
Is that your version of an apology?
I love it.
Did you guys have sex?
Thank you.
I love it. I love it. I don't care. I love it.
You got the touch. You got the power.
Guys, The Girl Most Likely, Kristen Wiig, I love her. She was a lead in Bridesmaids, and that was her second lead role film.
I like that this one is a little bit more serious.
Yeah.
You get to see her in a slightly different light. Although in Bridesmaids, she was complaining a lot and sad a lot as well. Like, but I feel this is more centered on her and her issues rather than her and her friend's issues.
Yeah, no, I love that Kristen Wiig's always like, she's like the out of place person that you find endearing and that you can kind of like relate to because she's not having a superstar life. But yeah. The thing is like you said, it's about the funny moments. Like watching a trailer, I'm kind of like, what is her conflict? What's going on? What's the story? But yet I'm like, it doesn't matter because there's gonna be so much funny dialogue.
Yeah.
Her ability to just completely be in a character, especially with SNL. I love it when any of the SNL guys do a more serious role. I mean, Will Ferrell's best role is Stranger Than Fiction.
Stranger Than Fiction.
That was really good. Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Well, like, same with, like, Jim Carrey started it all. When he went and did a serious film.
Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. Well, there was that. Well, I also did Truman Show, which was kind of a comedy. Man on the Moon. Oh, Man
Great.
On the Moon.
Yeah.
So, I feel like comedic actors can really hone in on the drama of things because so many comedic films are based in horrible human issues that we're dealing with. We're just being dorks about it and laughing at it.
I have another title for this film. Black Less Lightly. No black friends?
Matt Dillon.
Matt Dillon.
I love Matt Dillon.
He is
delusional.
Just he's always like that.
Lying all the time and dating like, the old woman.
Yeah, this role is like Straight Out of Something by Mary.
Yeah.
I was like, he's that character where he's like pretending to be somebody else and... Because it's something about Mary, he pretended to be...
Something about Mary as well.
I feel like I haven't seen him in a long time.
Yeah, a long time. Can't think of the last thing. The last thing I really remember him being in is something
funny.
About Mary.
He's funny at this.
He's hilarious.
So glad he's back,
Darren Criss.
He's the guy from Glee.
Oh, is he?
Yeah. The big name, but I didn't even recognize
him. Don't get me started on Glee.
I've never seen Glee.
I don't watch Glee, but yeah.
Is there black people in Glee?
Yes.
Oh wait, he does look
familiar.
Well,
that's not why I'm saying it then.
It's like set in Jersey, and I think that was really Jerseyed out for a little bit because everything, all reality shows are Jersey. But I'm actually looking forward to all the little, like, her mom's haircut, everything,
her outfit. What casino was that?
Atlantic City.
Okay.
You need to go to AC because it makes you feel so good about yourself. You're walking the floor and you're like, better than that person, better than that person. You see these old ladies walking around and they literally have like a keychain just full of the like loyalty cards.
Oh,
it's crazy.
Girl Most Likely. Guess you go see in theaters. Let us know what you think. And you should subscribe. If you don't subscribe, we're going to
make Jake do insanity.
Yeah, we're going to make Jake do insanity.
I don't know what that is.
Yeah.
I don't know
what
that is.
And I'm going to film it all.
I don't want to know what that is.
You don't want to know what
so
it is.
So subscribe, please.
It's the Cinema Couch. Give them a round of applause. It's the Cinema Couch. Give them a round of applause. It's the Cinema Couch. Give them a round of applause. C-I-N-E-M-A-C-O-U-Z-H. It's the Cinema Couch. Give them a round of applause. It's the Cinema Couch. Give them a round of applause. It's the Cinema Couch.